Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for your headline bout of the evening. Five rounds for the Glory Lightweight Championship of the World between a Lumpini Stadium champion and a Belgium beast. This bout sanctioned by the International Sport Kickboxing Association. At the opening bell, your referee, Tobias Gerald. For those with us live inside a sold-out Koenig Pilsner Arena and Glory fans watching from Deutschland to Detroit, it's time for Glory! Let's meet the challenger. Fighting out of the black corner, a former World Max champion with three knockouts in one night. His record, 48 wins with 9 losses, 2 bouts scored even, 29 of those wins by knockout. At 5 feet 10 inches tall, 1.78 meters, he weighed in at an even 153 pounds, 69.4 kilos. Fighting out of Belgium, he is the number one lightweight contender in the world, Marat Grigorian! His opponent fighting out of the white corner, a two-time Glory Contender Tournament champion. His professional record, 112 wins, 30 losses, 5 bouts scored even with 30 career knockouts. At 5 feet, 8.5 inches, 1.74 meters, he weighed in at 151 and 1/2 pounds, 68.8 kilos. Fighting out of Thailand, he is the reigning and defending Glory Lightweight Champion of the World, the Killer Kid, Sitthichai Sitsongpeenong. Once again, your referee, Tobias Gerald.
Gentlemen, okay, this is 5 rounds for the Glory Lightweight World Championship. So you know the rules, respect my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. Fight good, fight clean, fight hard. May the best man win. Any questions from the challenger? Any questions from the champion? Touch gloves, back to your corners. Back to the corner. Judge. Ready, fight!
The Glory lightweight title is on the line. Sitthichai in the white gloves and orange shorts, and the challenger, Marat Grigorian, in the black gloves.
And right away, it's Sitthichai's southpaw that gives a lot of people trouble. He's very good at managing distance, keeping space, and launching that left kick.
Ron Kruk, Joseph Valtellini, Whitney Miller, and Todd Grisham here for Glory 36 in Germany.
Fight.
No one has worked harder to capture a Glory title than Sitthichai. He won 2 Glory Contenders tournaments and then captured the title.
And he had 2 very tough title fights with Robin Van Roosmalen, which could have gone, both fights could have gone both ways.
Interesting talking with Sitthichai, Joseph. No, he is known for his high kicks, and he realized Glory judges were not scoring those kicks when his opponent were blocking those high kicks. He said he's going to start going to the body more, but then he throws a high kick as I'm saying that.
So Thais do a really good job at cracking the shell, they call it, using that left kick to really break down the defense. And Sitthichai, when he was fighting Robin, wasn't really getting scored and counting those strikes, so him and his team really want to mix up those kick levels a little bit more. Attack the legs and go high.
No knockdown for Grigorian, but that will help him in his confidence taking on the champion. Grigorian looks fast tonight.
It looks like Sitthichai could be cut.
Watch your head.
I agree. There is some blood, maybe on the forehead of Sitthichai.
This is what Grigorian really needs to do. Stay in the pocket to avoid that left kick. And if Sitthichai is going to throw that left kick, counter right back.
Minute to go in round number one. We are scheduled for 5. And Grigorian has that power. 29 knockouts out of his 48 victories. He can cut an opponent quickly.
I have no idea where that cut came from.
Push kick from Sitthichai.
When two fighters really fight in close distance, it's easy for two heads to clash.
Yeah, and they came out with a ferocious pace here to start off the first round. Easily could have been a headbutt.
Rick!
It's tough to see. Knee from Sitthichai to the body.
Sitthichai has very dangerous left knees, and I'm sure he'll use them as the fight progresses.
Well, Marat Grigorian showing that he does pack some power in those punches, was pushing Sitthichai back throughout that first round as his team goes to work on the cut. Yeah, right on the hairline, forehead of Sitthichai as we check out the action.
Oh, there it is, the two heads clashing as Sitthichai was trying to close distance and Marat was trying to get inside to land some punches. Both heads clashed, which is very unfortunate in the first round to happen.
And then Grigorian got that shot through, but it was not ruled a knockdown.
Yeah, it looked more like a slip in my opinion, more like a push rather than an effective strike, but that was a very close round. But I do have to give the advantage to Grigorian in that round. Sitthichai may be slowed down by that cut, so he needs to pick up the pace a little bit in round two.
Watch your head, guys. Fight!
Referee Tobias Gerald warning both fighters to watch the headbutts as we get underway. Round number two, Sitthichai and Grigorian. Sitthichai told us he really thought Grigorian, his overall kickboxing game has gotten much better from the first time that they fought. When they met that first time, he used only punches, and now he's really added some solid kicks to his arsenal.
Yeah, he's really countering well. And you see Grigorian really use that inside low kick. And Robin was very successful in their two fights, countering that left kick with a right inside low kick.
Who'd you give that first round to, Joseph?
I give it to Grigorian for being a little bit more active. And again, looking at those arm kicks, they weren't really doing damage. And Sitthichai's really trying to attack the leg, but they're not doing much damage.
Sitthichai got a solid shot through there. Kick distribution just about even between these two. Under 2 minutes to go in round two. Sitthichai with that Muay Thai background. Ties as we take a timeout. Notorious for starting slow, and in this Glory lightweight title fight, it is scheduled for five, so unlike the 3 minute rounds, you can start a little bit slower and then come on late.
And Thai fighters are really used to fighting five rounds. All Muay Thai belts are five rounds, so most of Sitthichai's career have been five round fights. Where Grigorian comes from more of a kickboxing background, where he's used to three rounds.
Sitthichai punching through, landed a couple nice shots.
Good straight left by Sitthichai.
Sitthichai catches the leg. Grigorian tumbles to the canvas. No knockdown.
Fight!
Outside low kick from Grigorian. Grigorian blocks the body kick thrown from Sitthichai. Sitthichai, the Rakhmini Stadium
champion, holding both of you.
Doesn't get more impressive than that in Thailand. Making his first title defense here tonight in Germany. Knees from Sitthichai.
Yeah, Sitthichai's knees are very dangerous, and I'm surprised he's not using them enough as Grigorian keeps coming forward. Sitichai's got to use that kick and slip in those knees.
Speaking of slipping in, he got a few jabs through the defense of Grigorian.
Are you okay? Fight!
Oh. Fighters clinch as
watch your head.
Wrap up
fight.
Round number two. Oh. Nick Hemmers giving instructions to Marat Grigorian as we check out the Glory Fight Metrics report.
And you can see the difference is Grigorian is more of a power style fighter where he goes in and he finishes his opponents. And you can see his average fight time only being 6 minutes and 38 seconds, but Sitthichai's with 10 minutes, but that's because Sitthichai has had more title fights in Glory than Grigorian. But both guys are very accurate and very good defensive.
Final instructions to Sitthichai. Looks like that headbutt cut that he suffered in the first round is taken care of. No more blood coming out of that.
Watch your head.
Fight! Fighters touch gloves. And we are set. Round number three. Sitthichai in the white gloves and the orange shorts. Grigorian in the black gloves. An exchange in the center of the Glory ring. Sitthichai might have taken one below the belt.
Good straight left by Sitthichai, followed by that left high kick.
He's picking up the pace, and Sitthichai grabs the leg and sweeps down Grigorian. No knockdown on that.
He needs to be careful, though. Referee Tobias Gerald warned Sitthichai for sweeping that leg.
Both of you, watch your heads, guys. Fight!
And once again, telling him to watch the headbutts. They both come in head first.
I want to see Sitthichai keep using that knee. He actually came in with his Glory debut, knocking out Kyria with that left knee to the body.
It's Grigorian who throws the knee and backs Sitthichai up. Under two to go in round three. Grigorian pushing the pace here. But in total knee strikes, it's Sitthichai hitting 8 out of 10.
Grigorian really needs to counter with his punches after those knees. But Sitthichai is
very
good at managing distance, staying outside or staying inside to avoid those punches.
Just past the midway point of this championship fight. Grigorian goes up high, whips. Here comes Sitthichai.
Yeah, Grigorian's output has slowed down.
Yeah.
It could be that left straight or those knees of Sitthichai that keep slowing him down, but Sitichai's doing a good job at throwing straight punches versus the forward movement of Grigorian.
Well, Sitthichai is just such a veteran fighter, as we said, over 140 pro bouts on his resume. A ton of tournament experience, too. He's won 5 tourneys in the past 2 years.
Yeah, these Thai fighters are so used to fighting so often. So for them, it's not a big deal. And even that cut over Sitichai's head there, he's probably been cut so many times with elbows in fights that it's no big deal for him.
That's a great point. 140 total fights, and he's only 25. And he's probably had many more as he started fighting at 11 years old. Seconds left to go. Nick Hemmer's yelling to Marat Grigorian to throw that low kick.
Yeah, he needs to counter a little bit more.
Use
that inside low kick.
Fight.
That he even Grigorian found success with in the last fight. Needs to keep countering with that shot.
Watch your head, okay? Fight!
That's it for round number three. Again, Nick Hemmer's in the face of Grigorian, but let's find out a little bit more about the champion, Sitthichai.
And Sitthichai is making his first title defense, and he had a tough run to get that title fight, having to have 2 contender tournaments and having 2 shots against Van Roosmalen, and finally he was able to win the title back at Glory 31 Amsterdam. Marat Grigorian is the current K-1 welterweight champion. Also has a lot of fight experience outside of the Glory ring, and his record is 3 wins, 3 losses, and 1 draw in Glory. But it doesn't really show the amount of fights and the talent he really does have and the power he packs in his strikes.
And that head kick KO
over
Glory 30 LA was an incredible knockout. It made ESPN's top 10. Sitthichai goes down, but no knockdown ruled. Championship rounds here. The Glory lightweight championship bout between Sitthichai and Grigorian.
Now, this is a very tough fight to score already. I gave Grigorian round one. Round two is a very close round that could have gone both ways, but I think Sitthichai stole round three. Very interesting and very tough to score.
Total strikes. Grigorian has thrown 199, landing 64, compared to Sitthichai's 171. He's landed 90.
Sitthichai is not as active, but he is landing a lot more. And seems to be doing a lot of damage with that left strike and those left knees.
And that's what the judges are looking for after number of knockdowns. They're looking at damage inflicted on your opponent. Here goes Sitthichai with his patented kicks to the arms.
Marat's not really countering as much anymore, and he's throwing shots more in singles and doubles.
Breaks the
in
back.
The first round, when he was more successful, he was throwing more in combinations.
He's letting Grigorian's pace seems to have been slowing down. Just
yeah, it's definitely slowing down, and his counter shots aren't doing as much. But he needs to be active, and he really needs to push the pace against Sitthichai, because Sitthichai is going to keep managing distance like he's doing now and picking his shots.
Grigorian is one of those guys who has been knocking on the title door for quite some time, but just has lost to the division elite. Of course, including Sitthichai, as we said, also Adam Chuck and Bruce Mullen. Can't get over that hump. There's a couple good shots from Grigorian, backs up Sitthichai.
That's what he needs to do, get a little bit more active. But he keeps forgetting about that inside low kick. Keep countering with that kick. There he goes.
Ooh, just misses with the high kick. Sitthichai was backing up. He moves forward and throws a knee.
Both guys exchanging kicks.
Right.
I want to see Grigorian be first more, not constantly wait for the counter shot.
Under 30 to go in round four, scheduled for five. Grigorian's lightweight title on the line.
Grigorian's looking for that uppercut, so maybe it's that shot on the inside.
Right. Right.
In their last fight, both guys did a good job at landing uppercuts.
Two counter strikes from Sitthichai. Get through as round number four comes to an end. Well, you had Sitthichai up two rounds to one. Joseph, who'd you give that fourth round to?
I still have to give that the round to Sitthichai. Based on, you know, clean scoring strikes, he seems to be the one landing those nice straight left, good left kicks to the leg, and good knees. Grigorian is coming forward, but in my opinion, he's waiting a little too long. And he needs to be first and not constantly wait to counter, because Sitthichai does a good job at either exiting or closing distance, making it really hard for Grigorian to get going.
Grigorian said about this third fight with Sitthichai, it's personal. He felt that he won that last fight at Glory 28 in Paris.
Last round, final round. Fight!
Fifth and final round, the Glory lightweight title on the line. Sitthichai, Grigorian. And here we go.
This fight could easily be up to this round. And if you gave Grigorian that second round, it's two rounds apiece.
And remember, Joseph, we have five judges scoring this bout here in Germany tonight. How does that change things up compared to the normal three?
Well, I personally like the five judges because there's more eyes on the fight, and there's more of a chance that the right decision is going to be called.
I agree. More eyes, like you said earlier, you know, you can see a shot get through, but if you've got a bad angle, you know, you might not think the damage was
breaks
done,
the back.
The judge might, but more eyes on the fight is always a good thing.
And especially with a fight like this where It could easily come to this last round. It'll be interesting to see what the judges are seeing.
Of course, the young Dylan Salvador won our Glory Lightweight Contenders Tournament. He will earn a title shot against either the champion Sitthichai or Grigorian some point next year.
Step back.
Check out break, break. Sitthichai's fight. Corner, shouting instructions to the top. Sitthichai always so relaxed, doesn't show much emotion, very soft-spoken. He got a nice stiff jab through there.
Yeah, his straight left, it seems to be his best weapon in this fight. But he's getting his lead leg swept out of him. That's where I like when Grigorian throws his punches and finishes with the inside low kick.
Minute to go, round number five. Can Grigorian steal the belt from the champion Sitthichai?
Stop!
Fighters clinch. Stop. Will be separated.
Fight! You gotta look at every time Grigorian throws that inside low kick, Sitichai's leg is being swept out and moved out of the way, and that's showing inflicted damage. So the referees could be really scoring that more than that straight left of Sitichai.
Under 30 to go. But as in any title fight, the challenger usually needs to do something to take that belt away from the champion. Has Marat Grigorian accomplished that tonight?
Oh.
Slip.
Fight!
10 seconds to go. Grigorian swinging for the fences, but it's Sitthichai that lands another stiff jab. Oh. Lightweight title is up for grabs. It's in the hands of the judges. We'll get the decision coming up next. Lightweight title fight just went down here in Germany as we check out some of the highlights.
And with the early pressure of Grigorian, that seemed to do a lot of good damage. He stayed in the pocket, threw some good punches. But Sitthichai, as the fight slowly progressed, was able to find good success with his left straights. And he didn't throw as much arm kicks like they promised. And they started attacking that rear leg and did a little bit more damage with those knees. But ultimately, it's a tough fight to call. Both guys were able to exchange good shots. And it's going to come down to, in my opinion, the clean scoring strikes. And the one that stands out are those knees by Sitthichai, landing 21 out of his 27.
Both fighters very active, though, in this fight. You look at the strikes absorbed. Grigorian took a lot of head and body shots, where it was Sitthichai really getting beat down on the legs.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five championship rounds, we go to the judges' scorecard. Here are the totals. They score this bout 49-46, Sitthichai. 48-47, Grigorian. Our final three judges score it 48-47, 49-47, and 48-47. A split decision, all for your winner. And still, Glory Lightweight Champion of the World, Sitthichai Sitsongpeenong. Here to present the belt, our Chief Executive Officer, Mr. John Franklin, and our Head of Talent Operations, Mr. Core Hammers.
Sitthichai, congratulations on the victory. What do you feel was the difference for you tonight?
Today, his opponent was really strong. But he think he win because he used his brain more and he fight more clever than his opponent.
This is the third time you fought Marat Grigorian and your third victory. Why are you able to be so successful against him?
วันนี้ครั้งที่3ที่ชกกับมาราดคิดยังไงทําไมสิริชัยเก่งกว่าก็ผมทําเต็มที่ของผมแล้วคือผมดีกว่าแต่ว่าคู่ต่อสู้ก็เก่งเหมือนกันครับผมก็ยอมรับเขาครับเขาเก่งเหมือนกัน
He said, again, he's really strong opponent. He's really, really good, but how to say?
Well, you've got his number.
Just better for today, yeah?
Congratulations once again, ladies and gentlemen. Give it up. And still, lightweight champion of the world, Sitthichai Sitsongpeenong.